This week, there were left-leaning blogs and social media posts charging that President Trump had declared bankruptcy on a golf court in Puerto Rico and left the Puerto Rican government liable for tens of millions of dollars worth of bonds. In the early 2000s, the Puerto Rican government was hoping to bolster the island's hospitality industry, so they backed bonds to finance the development of hotels and resorts. The Cocoa Beach Golf and Country Club, which opened in 2004, was backed by these bonds to the tune of $25.5 million. The recession hit Puerto Rico hard, and by 2008, the resort was heading toward bankruptcy. That same year, Trump agreed to license his name and manage the resort as the Trump International Golf Club Puerto Rico. But it kept struggling, and in 2011, it took on another bond offering for $28 million. But Trump wasn't a meaningful part of this decision. The official documents show that the Puerto Rican government knew just how much money the resort was losing, yet lent the money anyway. In 2015, the property filed for bankruptcy, leaving Puerto Rican taxpayers with a $33 million debt, which is less than 5% of the island's overall debt. So sure, Trump shares some of the blame for failing to turn the club around, but blaming him for contributing to the Puerto Rican debt is a shade too far. The recession was a major factor in the property's financial problems.